There are lands that have been occupied in 1967, and if we talk about international law, then withdrawal is the, you know, is essential. It would defy the idea that this land was without people and was without agriculture.
We in Breaking the Silence are working to expose the truth, the reality of the occupation, of what it means to control millions of people with a military force, what it entails, what we as soldiers took part in, what we did, you know, home invasions, military training over the Palestinian population.
On peut pas continuer avec les lois, avec les revendications religieuses sur la terre, avec l'utilisation de la Bible pour justifier l'injustice, pour justifier l'occupation de la terre et l'occupation de tout un peuple.
The people of Israel occupied the land of Canaan, the land of another people. He must justify his possession of the land by loving the stranger, for he himself was a stranger in exile. We are in fact all immigrants, temporary guests on this earth, which truly belongs only to our common creator.
Challenge positions that are about the conflict, that are exclusive, militaristic, apocalyptic, mainly by evangelicals in the West, mainly in North America.
We are able to discuss differences in a constructive way that makes the conversation richer and makes it more interesting. It doesn't threaten the conversation. And through that, we train ourselves to develop friendships with people we disagree with.
We believe that the world's great religions all make a huge, or potentially make a huge contribution to peace, because they have ancient wisdom, and if the wisdom of religions is harnessed, it will in fact be making peace. We pray because we believe that praying together is an act of peace and has a power and force of its own.
Je crois beaucoup à la force de la société civile pour développer et construire la confiance entre Israéliens et Palestiniens.
If you want to do one thing to advance peace, it's to learn the language of the person on the other side and try and connect with them in where they are. And I think if we all spoke the same language, it would make a huge contribution towards living together and breaking down the cultural barriers that exist between us.
Through face-to-face meetings and joint programs, we try to begin healing what I call the hubris of exclusivity, that disease that leads both sides to deny the existence, the narrative, and legitimacy of the other side.
And using our personal stories of transformation as an example to inspire other people to join the struggle that as a grassroots activist we have to take our destiny to our hands.
We believe our long-term goal is to create a framework for a reconciliation process to be an integral part of any future political peace agreement. Without that, at best, all we can have is a ceasefire. You will see the transformation of people from hatred once we can make the emotional breakthrough by telling stories.
We need to educate the Israeli population, and we need to try to push the Israeli government. The only way that Israelis will feel safe and that will Israel prosper and reach its goals is through peace.
Que personne ne mette en cause la légitimité de la présence de l'autre sur cette terre. Chacun a l'impression que l'autre veut le détruire. Pour les uns, les rejeter à la mer, pour les autres, les rejeter au désert. Ce devrait être chaque camp qui neutralise ces extrémistes.
Il me paraît capital pour la diplomatie palestinienne de ne pas pratiquer la politique de la chaise vide, de consentir opérationnellement à la normalisation, à condition de réintroduire dans cette normalisation un ingrédient qui tienne compte des revendications et des droits des Palestiniens. S'il n'y a pas la paix, c'est que ni l'un ni l'autre n'exigent de leur peuple qu'ils fassent tout ce qui est en leur possible pour arriver à la paix. Qu'ils doivent prendre de part et d'autre des décisions douloureuses. Et s'ils ne prennent pas ces décisions, c'est parce que de part et d'autre, côté palestinien comme côté israélien, on n'est pas entièrement convaincu que la présence des Juifs et des Arabes sur cette terre est légitime.
80% of peace around the world start by grassroots movement, putting pressure with middle level on the top layers, diplomacy to come to the solution. The hero is the one that holds the power of the gun. The hero is a peacemaker. Blessed are the peacemaker. I'm calling upon the international young people, peacemakers all around the world. You can make a difference. Let's work together.
As women wage peace, as women committed to peace and to an intersectional or an inclusive approach to peace, we are committed to keeping this radical hope for a peaceful future for Israel and for Palestine. Yes, it is possible, and peace will come.
Once we have justice on the ground, once we fulfill our own national rights, our self-determination, you'll find a hospitality unmatched in the world.
I believe with my full heart that it is the will of God that we are back in our own homeland. But I do not believe that it is a mistake of God that there is also another people living here, and we're not doomed to live together, but we are fortunate to live together. This is fulfilling God's will, but it is possible to make peace. And the goal of making peace is to mend the world with the kingdom of God.
So I will talk a little bit about the hope that exists. First of all, we have a lot of peace builders, people who truly believe that peace is possible on both sides, despite the difficulties and despite being a Palestinian. As a peacemaker, you are viewed as a normalizer, as a traitor to the cause. We also have a lot of peace initiatives that already exist and can be a very good basis for beginning of negotiations. For example, the Geneva Initiative, but also the Arab Peace Initiative, which we should actually be pushing for. Also in Jerusalem, there is hope. There is civil society in Jerusalem that is trying to build bridges between the East and the West. And they are actually supporting many initiatives whereby they're bringing these activists together to show that Jerusalem can be an example of a shared city.
The Israeli-Palestinian conflict, which is located in the Holy Land and in Jerusalem, concerns the three Abrahamic religions and all the world. It needs the international community that can be a mediation. Religions can play a positive role, as the overwhelming majority of believers share essential values for peace. Love of the other, sharing, forgiveness, and reconciliation. The dialogue is urgent, as the Palestinian anger is deeply anchored and can be explored at the next occasion. When occupation and settlement stop, when there is a will to share, there can be a real security and peace in justice, equality, and freedom.
Hey.